Hi guys. Here at Newgate we grow most of our plants from little seedlings like this. So we don't buy in the finished article and just sell it on to you, we grow them on ourselves. A lot of these we produce ourselves, some that we buy in. For example, this is a begonia. It's the everlasting begonia, the non-stop begonia. The one that's probably the most popular bedding plant that you can buy. This is a plug that you can buy from us now and then grow on and then reap the benefits in the summer. These sort of plugs cost about 50p, and these include all sorts of things from trailing petunias to verbenas, all the bedding plants you can imagine. Some of the seed raised bedding plants like begonias and busy lizzies, they're quite a bit cheaper. They work out at about 20 pence each. Okay, it doesn't matter on any amount, you can just give us a ring and we'll send them to you. Alright, so plugs are a good thing this time of year, especially if you've got a greenhouse, if you're starting to think about summer planting and growing them yourself. Yeah. Now I'm going to show you how we make some of our, there's different ways of growing the plants. So a lot of these plants are grown from seed, but also a lot of the others are grown from something called cuttings, or asexual reproduction if you want to be technical. But basically taking part of the tissue of the plant, making it root to form a new plant. So you get exactly the same, there's no variation, where with seed, if you sow the seed sometimes, the flowers or the flower colour can change, the plant form can change. So to be totally true, you take a cutting. All your hanging basket plants, your bacopas, your trailing verbenas, your bid ends, anything you can imagine is always taken from cuttings. And we do a lot of our own. So if you want to come to the cuttings bench, and I'll show you a great thing to do with kids, will be to take some cuttings, you can put them on a windowsill, and then you can have a competition to see who can get the plant to grow first. Okay, so I'll show you how to take the cuttings, dead simple, and then you can try it at home. Come on. Okay guys, so these are some of the cuttings that we took probably about four weeks ago. As you can see, they've come up, they're starting to root nicely. This is a really warm, heated bed, and above it, as you can see here, they're little misters. So these come on every so often and keep the leaf moist. It's very important when you turn a root of cutting that you give it some warmth at the bottom and moisture on the leaf, because plants are always losing moisture out of the leaf. It's called transpiration, if we're being technical, but basically they're sweating. And if you don't put that moisture back in, then they're gonna die. So what you need to do when you're doing cuttings, you need to replicate what we've got here at home. And the easiest way to do that is to get yourself a pot. These are little cardboard pots that we can supply. Get your Jack's Magic or a nice fine cuttings compost in there. You can use the evergreen multi-purpose or the Jack's Magic. Firm it in quite well, not too tight, but just firm enough, and then wet the top, okay? So it's moist already. You don't want to be watering it afterwards and then knocking the cuttings everywhere. Okay, so I'm going to take cuttings, these are tip cuttings, and we're going to take them with fuchsias. Okay, this variety is Marinka, nice red trailing fuchsia. So what we're looking at when you're taking a cutting is you want to go directly under the leaf node. Okay, so I've taken this tip cutting because these will root quicker. If you, the higher up the plant you go, the faster they'll root basically. So see that there, we just nip it off. Okay, then I'm just going to nip it a bit closer and then take the leaves off. Okay, so that's all we're left with. Now all the strength for the rooting is in this little bit here, because where the leaves join, we'll go back to that again there, that's where all the hormones in the plant exist. And they're called auxins, the hormones that make roots. Okay, now what you can do to help this along, a bit of a cheat for the kids, is the rooting hormone. So we sell this here, okay. And it's organic. So organic rooting powder is 99.8% talcum powder and the rest of it, so chalk basically, and the rest of it is auxin, which is the thing they need to root, which is naturally occurring in the plant, but you're giving it a bit of a help. So once you've taken the cutting, you've took the leaves off, dip it in, okay, and then that's ready to go in. Then we'll take three. So when you're doing a pot like this, three is ideal. If all three root, you're going to get a bushy plant, because you'll have three stems in it. If only one roots, at least you've still got a plant. Okay, so we take all three like that. Okay, so in January, at the nursery, we're doing this all day, every day. Now then, you need something to pop them in with, so I've just got this plant label, anything will do, little bamboo stick or anything. And then we're going down the side of the pot, if you can. Not bang on the edge, because your little cloche that we're going to put over in a minute will disturb it, but as close as you can to the edge. The reason is, roots like to touch something. So when they start to grow, if they can hit a surface, then they know they can go down and they're a lot happier. So you can see we've got the three fuchsias in there now. Now, in order to get that humidity round and the water droplets forming round the foliage, we need to put something over them. So there's an old water bottle here. Everyone's got them. Just chop the top off and just bob them in like that. If you put that now on your windowsill, I'll get it out without destroying it. As you can see there, it's a mini greenhouse. Just keep it watered. You can just water it around the edges. They'll take it up. Don't overwater it. Keep it moist. Keep it on a windowsill. The kids can do this at home. And let's see who can get them rooted first. Okay. And if they want to send the pictures to our Facebook account, that'd be fantastic. And there might be a prize to see who can get those roots through first. Okay. That'd be grand.
Dostras.
At this time of crisis, and the country's all pulling together, we really need to thank our key workers and our NHS staff, because without them, we'd be in trouble. So what we're doing at Newgate to thank them is four of these planters every week are going to be given away to some of our local key workers. We need you guys to either comment on this video, this YouTube video, or go on our Facebook site and basically give us the names of the people that you think deserve these. We'll then contact you, get their address, and we'll drop them off at their door. All right, this is a little thank you from Newgate to the workers. Thank you.